Good morning students, this is mobile computing video lecture. Today we are going to discuss about the unit number 5. There are major topics are there to discuss. Now let us see the discussion topics. These are the topics we are going to discuss today. So basically introduction to mobile operating system and main responsibilities of mobile operating system and OS basic concepts and monolithic microkernel architecture. Some special constraints and requirement to design the operating system, and there are some few examples for commercial mobile operating system. Finally, we are going to discuss about the software development kit in that iOS and Android platforms we are going to discuss. This is the introduction to mobile operating system. So nowadays smartphones are not only used for just phone calls, so it's also carrying the following features like making video call, sending the multimedia message, taking pictures, playing the music file, access to the internet, I mean the browsing all the documents, and installing and running any web application. So this is the reason that we need a powerful mobile version of the operating system to handle all the above tasks. So the design of the mobile operating system is one of the very tough job to handle all the activities like a desktop and laptop computers. These are the main responsibilities of operating systems. One is managing the resources, another one is providing different interfaces. So what is the reason for managing resources? Phone, this is a handheld device. It is also having the set of resources inbuilt: phone processor, phone memory, phone speaker, keyboard and video screen. So the major role of the operating system is to make the efficient utilization of the mobile device resources. Basically, if you want to do voice communication, text messaging, email, video play, music play, recording, browsing or running any remote application, we need the processor, phone memory, speaker, keyboard and all the other resources. So the utilization is very important to make the optimization. Next one is providing different interfaces, because highly interactive interface is required. Why? Because of the mobile phone not only doing all the above features, it will interact with the other mobile phone, it will interact with the desktop computer, laptop computer, connect to the network, communicating with the printers or scanner, whatever the peripheral devices attached with this wireless or wired network. So it need a clear interface to communicate. So the main responsibilities are managing the resources, another one is providing different interfaces. These are the basic concepts of operating system. Just want to recall you. Operating system is basically a central interface. It providing the services to various application program. It will supervise the computer as well as respond to the user commands. Basically, it is running in two modes. One is supervisor mode, another one is user mode. Supervisor mode means it will start to execute all the system related routine, system programs, peripheral related communication, what are the devices attached to this. All the communication related to the internal and external part of the devices, wireless or wired, that will do the execution of system-oriented programs in supervisor mode. User mode, it will only execute the user applications like a Word file, Excel file, PowerPoint file, browser, whatever the user application, that will do the task accordingly. The popular classic examples are the Unix and Windows OS family version of the operating system, which are very popular. Now we can see the design of operating system comes under two different architecture. One is a monolithic kernel architecture, another one is microkernel architecture. Monolithic kernel architecture means the maximum number of responsibilities are only in operating system. So in a supervisor mode, operating system will take the responsibility of managing all the computer peripherals, resources, and making the connection, communication, running all the system programs, installing the device driver, whatever that all the responsibilities are with only operating system. So it will take the major role and the bulk of workloads with the operating systems to handle the computer peripherals as well as the execution of application program. The only the situation is if any bug or any problems are with the kernel mode, I mean supervisor mode. The alternative name for supervisor mode is called kernel mode. In that, if any problems are coming there, then immediately the operating system may crash. So in this situation, it is very difficult to debug the kernel because a huge number of programs codings are written in supervisor mode. So many support and additional service packs also required to write to support the operating system basic functionalities. So in monolithic kernel architecture, that operating system role is a very heavyweight role. In microkernel architecture, after designing the operating systems, the OS developers, they proposed the new architecture called microkernel architecture. So first we will see the monolithic kernel architecture, how the structure is designed. See the hardware part of the computer. There is another one called hardware interface layer. This interface layer is very important to communicate with various number of peripherals, like a video monitor, keyboard, mouse, trackball, joystick, or even with a CD-ROM drive, with other any printer or scanner, any type of devices, network cables. So hardware interface layer is very important to communicate. Next layer is called set of device drivers. See the device drivers are there. First one is device driver, network drivers, graphics drivers, and terminal drivers. The drivers are system programs specifically written very complex routines to communicate with the particular individual peripherals. Device drivers are written to communicate with the printer, scanner, CD-ROM drive, like other peripheral devices. Network drivers are written to communicate with the outside of the world, connecting to the local area network, connecting to the internet, accessing the web pages. So the network drivers are written. Graphics drivers. So graphics drivers are very important to make the standard graphical user interface in the video display monitor. Terminal drivers are used to connect with the input-output console, such as keyboard, mouse, trackball, or maybe with a joystick, whatever it may be. Next, you can see there are three more responsibilities are there with the operating system. One is a file system manager, process manager, and memory manager. File system manager, it will handle the creation of file, maintaining the records, organizing records, searching and retrieving the records, deleting the files in the entire file processing system. Process manager is a very important role. It will create the process, run the process, suspend the process temporarily, make the CPU scheduling, and also exit the application. Entire process management is with the control of process manager. Memory manager is another responsibility to allocate the memory, communicating with the primary memory, secondary memory, auxiliary memory, making the virtual memory, I mean swapping concept. Effective utilization of memory management is with the memory manager. So see, this entire architecture consists of multiple activities with a heavy workload. This is the operating system part in the monolithic kernel architecture. That entire structure is called kernel code. Now you can see the user mode of the programs. Only applications. See, the applications are running in user mode, very lightweight process, Word application, browser, Excel. They are communicating with the kernel mode. Kernel mode is executing all the applications, allocating resources, managing resources, communicating the resources, deallocation of resources after the end of the communication. So in monolithic kernel architecture, it is very difficult to debug the operating system code, as well as it is very difficult to control the operating system from abnormal to normal mode. In microkernel architecture, the problem has resolved. The designer of the operating system, they proposed the new model that transferring the file system, process manager, memory manager role into the user mode. So 50% of the workload getting reduced and shared between the kernel and user mode. Now you can see the microkernel architecture. See, in microkernel architecture, the operating system is only communicating with the hardware, maintaining the required device driver softwares, and making the request reply with the user mode. In user mode, the file processing system, file management, and process management, device management, everything is written as different servers. Process management with the process server, file management with the file server, display management with the display server. There are other servers also there. Now you see, in microkernel architecture, the size of the operating system code is getting reduced. If any errors or bugs are there, it is easy to debug the errors, and it is maximum we can try to avoid the crashing of operating system. The kernel structure only happy to communicate with the hardware and all other part of the peripherals only. This is another diagram which is downloaded from the internet. So in this diagram, you can see, understand this overall structure. The operating system is always busy with the hardware, CPU, RAM, and input-output system only, not with the other modules. The system software, application software, all these responsibilities are running in user mode. In microkernel architecture, the overall responsibility of the operating system is simplified. So this is the structure that is proposed by the operating system designers. Now the special constraints and requirements. Why the constraints and requirements are there? Like a desktop computer and laptop computer, in mobile operating system also specifically designed to do all the required operations. So in that, what is the basement? The basement is battery power. So to make the battery power with the effective utilization and optimization, so to limit the memory, limit the screen size, miniature of the keyboard, limiting the processing power, limited battery power, limited and fluctuating bandwidth of the wireless medium. So these are all the aspects that the operating system to take care of, making the effective utilization of the mobile resources. So it needs some special constraints. Constraints means set of rules and regulations to specifically make the effective plan to utilize the resources. Next one are the special requirements. Support for communication protocol. Support for communication protocol means it will communicate with the various devices like a mobile to mobile phone, mobile to wired network, maybe communicate with some different peripheral devices like printer, scanner, or maybe with any other connectivity. So it needed some communication protocol. Support for a variety of input mechanism. The variety of input mechanism means these are the major requirements to communicate through the USB interface, Bluetooth connectivity, Wi-Fi transfer, WiMAX transfer. So it needs separate input mechanism. Compliance with the open standards. It is also very important because the mobile phone is manufactured by one particular vendor to another vendor. The architecture may be dissimilar. The design of the processor may be dissimilar. So in this time, the open standards are required to make the communication between the dissimilar application and dissimilar networks. That what I am telling is that it is called interoperable services through the open standards. Extensive library support. It is very important to make the all type of email communication, file transfer, message transfer, voice call, video call. So it need a separate library file supports. So finally support the integrated development environment to make the GUI become very effective. So graphical user interface is very important. User objects, widgets to make everything is interactive. So it is also one of the major requirement. See, now these are the major function of the operating system: multitasking, scheduling, memory allocation, file system interface, keypad interface, input output interface, protection and security, multimedia features. This you can take it as the future of mobile operating system also. These are the commercial mobile operating systems: Windows Phone, Palm OS, iOS, Android, BlackBerry and Symbian OS. Now we can see the Windows Phone. So Windows Phone is the product of Microsoft. Microsoft is very strong in designing operating system. So the kernel code of the Windows operating system based on the desktop and laptop version of the Microsoft Win32 application. So the mobile operating system also meet the basic requirements of the Win32 application. So Win32 means Windows 32-bit operating system. It also maintains the same specifications, standard rules and regulations. The new version of the Windows Phone is called Windows CE. CE means Compact Edition or Embedded Compact, specifically designed for handheld devices. And initially it was proposed for personal digital assistant, palm top computer, packet PC. And later on, due to the increase of mobile users, that Microsoft Windows concentrated to write the mobile operating system for smartphones. This is the evolution of various mobile operating system from Microsoft. 1996 onwards it started. The first version is called Windows CE 1.0 and Windows CE 2.0 in 1997. Basically it targeted the personal digital assistants and palm top computers. Then Pocket PC version was released in 2000. And 2003 Windows Mobile released, which consists of actually three different versions. One is a standard edition, professional edition and classic edition. Standard and professional edition specifically written for smartphones and classic edition written for personal digital assistants and tablet PCs. Later on, Windows Phone 7 was written. In this particular period, Nokia had an alliance with the Microsoft Windows, and the Microsoft Windows released the mobile version for Nokia handset also. The Lumia type model was very popular in that time. Then 2012 Windows Phone 8 was released with the upgraded features due to the big screen and resolution, and various activities are incorporated. And later on Windows Mobile 10 was released in 2015. So these are the continuous successive generations and versions of the mobile operating system from Microsoft. This is Palm OS. Palm OS is basically targeted the personal digital assistants. It is a ARM architecture based processor. ARM means Advanced RISC Machine Architecture, 32-bit version designed specifically written for the wristwatch, handheld gaming, smartphones, barcode reader and GPS devices. See the structure of the Palm OS, it was really popular. Nowadays Palm OS is no more because due to the market dominance and other all the responsibilities and activities, the Microsoft, Google, Sony Ericsson and Samsung, HTC, these are the companies take lead in the mobile market. These are the additional feature. It is a single tasking operating system, effective memory management is there. It supplies a form emulator, it supports a handwriting recognition based system for user input, it is very interactive and supports the hard synchronization technology for data synchronization. Tight security system is there, it supports the sound playback and recording capability and connectivity with the various interfaces there, USB, infrared, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi connection. So Palm OS also it supported the Wi-Fi connection also. The other feature like a basic application feature, calendar, address book and note entries, task management and installing the any third party applications. This is iOS. iOS was initially called iPhone OS. In June 2010, it was renamed as iOS. It is a mobile operating system specifically designed for Apple computer and its own hardware. Later on, they released for iPhone, iPod touchscreen and Apple TV. You see the structure of iPhone with the iOS OS. It is very nice and interactive mobile handset. These are the additional information about the iOS. It is not enabled for cross-licensing. Specifically designed for Apple devices, it is based on the Unix version. The user interface also multi-touch screen gesture. There are four different layers also is there. The layers are core OS layer, core service layer, media layer and finally Cocoa touch layer. Initially the first version was released in 2007 and later on they released for iPad. And due to the bigger screen and increase of the smartphone, accordingly the various version of the operating systems also released. Android. Google is one of the responsible for Android development. They acquired the initial developer of Android operating system group and they formed the well-defined structure of the Android platform with the Open Handset Alliance, like with the 86 hardware, software and telecom companies. Then Android was very popular, still it is really popular, and maximum 65% of overall users and sharings are in the world with only the Android development, and remaining part is going to Microsoft and Samsung and other manufacturers. The alliance developed and announced by Android as a open source version of the mobile operating system. Now it is under the Apache license, so Android is really very popular. In the multi-shoot version, it is installing in any type of manufacturer based handheld devices. These are some additional information. So the Android is developed not only for the particular handheld devices like a Samsung, Motorola, HTC, LG, Sony also, that proper structure, the direct interface to install the Android OS, quickly it is reactive. Android developer community has developed large number of mobile applications, more than 450,000. It is also even old because now they have crossed more number of apps stored in Google Play Store. And several features are there like a VGA, 2D graphics based and 3D graphics based library, an effective interface, communication, very fast, quick transfer, easy to internet access, instant transactions, very lightweight relational database it maintains per storage. There are various connectivities there due to the features and advent of new technology. Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, WiMAX and other type of networks are there, messaging like SMS, MMS and Android cloud to device management, like a various number of features are there. Nowadays latest versions also coming with upgrade and effective communication features. Technology also getting updated in Android. So far we are discussing about the basics of mobile operating system structure and basic concepts of mobile operating system. Then we discussed about the special constraints and requirements, commercial mobile operating system, we discussed about the Windows Phone, Palm OS, iOS, then Android. So these are the one particular part of the Unit 5. So remaining will be continued in the next video session. Thank you.